हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम डॉक्टर योगेश पावड़े। आई वेलकम यू टू द नेक्स्ट सेशन इन जेनेटिक्स एंड मॉलिकुलर बायोलॉजी लेक्चर सीरीज अंडर द सेम कॉम्पिटेंसी BI 7.2। वी आर कवरिंग वेरियस डीएनए रिपेयर मैकेनिज्म्स एंड अंडर दीज डीएनए रिपेयर मैकेनिज्म वी हैव सो फार कवर्ड न्यूक्लियोटाइड एक्सीजन रिपेयर, बेस एक्सीजन रिपेयर, बोथ होमोलॉगस एंड नॉन होमोलॉगस एंड जॉइनिंग रिपेयर्स। सो आफ्टर कवरिंग दिस फोर मेजर रिपेयर सिस्टम्स इन डीएनए विल कवर टूडे द फोटो रिएक्टिवेशन, डीएनए मिसमैच रिपेयर, मिथिल ग्रुप रिमूवल फ्रॉम द मिथिलेटेड बेस मैकेनिज्म, देन ऑक्सो जी टू ए रिपेयर, रिकॉम्बिनेशनल रिपेयर एंड ट्रांसलिजनल डीएनए सिंथेसिस एज अ मैकेनिज्म ऑफ डीएनए रिपेयर। Today we will also enumerate various genetic disorders caused due to defective DNA repair. Now coming to the first one amongst the miscellaneous DNA repair systems, that is the photoreactivation, that is light induced repair. We all know because of UV light damage there are pyrimidine dimers formed, so maybe TT or CC pyrimidine dimers are formed. What mechanism in this DNA repair system corrects the error? There is assembly headed by DNA polymerase is responsible for correcting the error caused due to UV light. Okay, so what is DNA photolyase? It is a photoreactivating enzyme and it binds nucleotide-nucleotide dimers, that is thymine or cytosine in case of pyrimidine dimers. And after binding, it is activated by visible light energy, 300 to 600 nanometers. So, peculiar thing of special mention here is the damage is caused due to UV light. And now, the correction or the repair process is activated by the visible light energy, because the visible light energy activates DNA photolyase. This DNA photolyase will bring about cleavage of carbon-carbon bonds of the dimer. This dimer will be cleaved by DNA photolyase. It cleaves the CC bonds of the dimer. And once the CC bonds are cleaved, you know, it will lead to a monomeric condition of the DNA template. When the dimer is cleaved, monomeric condition will be restored. This was regarding photoreactivation or light induced repair through the agency of DNA photolyase enzyme. Then coming to mismatch repair of DNA, the mismatch repair corrects errors made when DNA is copied during the replication process. This mechanism will correct single mismatch base pair. Maybe there is a mismatch pair of C to A rather than thymine to adenine. So it needs to be corrected. So single mismatch base pair will be corrected by mismatch repair of DNA. This is also abbreviated as MMR, mismatch repair. Or it can correct a short region of unpaired DNA also. The defective region is recognized by an endonuclease enzyme that makes a single strand cut at an adjacent methylated GATC sequence. So methylated GATC sequence will be the region of cutting the single strand by endonuclease and initiate the process of mismatch repair. So methylated GATC sequence will be important in recognizing the site of single strand cut by endonuclease. Then the DNA strand is removed through the mutation. It will be replaced by DNA polymerase and it is ligated by DNA ligase enzyme. So this was mismatch repair of DNA. Now coming to the next DNA repair mechanism, that is methyl group removal from the methylated base. First of all, let us understand why DNA methylation is required, because DNA methylation is essential for, you know, silencing retroviral elements. During the evolution, viral DNA is also incorporated in our DNA. It needs to be silenced, otherwise we will be producing viral proteins. So DNA methylation will silence the retroviral elements, regulate tissue specific gene expression also. It have a role in genomic imprinting. Most important part is it inactivates X chromosome. So though X chromosome is present in males, it is inactivated by DNA methylation process. So DNA methylation is very important or crucial step in expression of genome. Most important is the gender expression. So if the undesired nucleotide gets methylated, so there will be an error, right? So methylation of the desired nucleotide is the target or the aim of the DNA repair system. So the methylation of undesired nucleotide needs to be get removed. So this is the mechanism with which we will correct the undesired methylated base. Okay, so there is a enzyme that is methyl transferase. It just removes the methyl group from 6-oxy group of methyl guanine by transferring it to one of its own cysteine residues. So the methyl transferase will, you know, grab the methyl group from the 6-oxy methyl guanine and it will retain the methyl group by its own cysteine residues. And because of that, this is just a kind of use and throw enzyme. So the methyl transferase is not catalytic. It will just accept the methyl group. And once it is accepted, it cannot be used again, because once accepted, the methyl group cannot be released from the enzyme. So this is just a kind of disposable or use and throw kind of enzyme molecule will be there. One methyl group is accepted and there is no longer use of that methylated methyl transferase enzyme. So this is what the methyl group removal mechanism from the undesired methylated base. Now coming to the oxo G2A repair. This is also the very common phenomenon in DNA molecule, that because of the oxidation, the nucleotides gets oxidized. Most common nucleotide which gets oxidized is guanine, and it will form oxo G. How to remove this oxo G? Usually, if the DNA replication doesn't occur before its removal, it will be removed by DNA glycosylase mechanism. We have understood that. Okay, so the kind of oxidated nucleotides will be removed by DNA glycosylase mechanism via base excision pathway. We have understood that base excision, it removes the base, then it removes the sugar, okay, and the DNA polymerase comes into role and it synthesizes the DNA to fill the gap, and the DNA ligase mechanism will ligate the DNA. This will happen when OxoG is corrected or repaired before the replication occurs. Now consider a condition when OxoG was not removed and replication has occurred. So if replication has occurred, what will happen? Usually the G combines with C, right? But OxoG combines with adenine. Here the replication has occurred and OxoG has combined with adenine. So to correct this error, there is a role of fail-safe glycosylase. This is a special DNA glycosylase termed as fail-safe glycosylase. This will correct the OxoG, it will remove adenine and it will allow cytosine to bind to guanine. In this way, this will provide a second opportunity for the DNA glycosylase to remove the modified base. So if replication has not occurred, usual DNA glycosylase will do the needful. If replication has occurred and OxoG is still there, it will bind to A during the replication process. Now that A has to be removed by C, so the fail-safe glycosylase will remove A and will incorporate cytosine. This was regarding OxoG to A repair. Now coming to the recombinational repair, or that is also called as sister strand exchange. Okay, so we have seen end joining repair, and in that case homologous end joining repair, we have seen the sister chromatid serve as a template for repair mechanism. But here the sister strand is cut and used to fill the gap opposite the dimer. So here the unmutated single stranded segment from homologous DNA is excised from the good strand and inserted into the gap opposite the dimer. So here the sister strand is used not as a template, but it is cut to fill the gap opposite the dimer. So this is the major difference between homologous end joining repair and the recombinational repair, that is also called assisted strand exchange. It occurs after the first round of the DNA replication, and especially this is used when both strands are damaged. What will be used as a template to fill the gap, because both the strands are broken. In such situation, one strand cannot serve as a template for the repair of the other. The mechanism needs to use assisted chromatid, but not like homologous end joining repair, but assisted strand exchange will cut that part and use it to fill the gap. In recombinational repair, that is also called as double strand break repair, sequence information is retrieved from the second undamaged copy of the chromosome. This was regarding recombinational repair or sister strand exchange. Coming to the last resort, that is translesion DNA synthesis. When damaged bases are still there, it blocks the progression of replicating DNA polymerase. So replication fork is stalled there, and to avoid the deleterious consequences of the stalled replication fork, cells use a specialized polymerase to traverse the damage. The usual DNA polymerase will stop if those polymerases find a damaged nucleotide in the DNA sequence. Those polymerases will stall and will not progress the replication. So if this happens, cell death is inevitable. So in such conditions, cell uses specialized polymerases to traverse the damage. Those specialized polymerases may correct the damage and progress the replication, or it can just skip the damaged nucleotide and progress the replication. So the special translational polymerase copies across the site of the damage in a manner that does not depend on base pairing between the template and newly synthesized DNA strand. And this process, affords the cell additional time to repair the damage before the replicase returns to complete genome duplication. Before the complete genome duplication occurs, the cell gets additional time by special translation mechanism to correct the damage. And that's why this is the last resort of DNA repair systems. This mechanism is an example of DNA damage tolerance. The extent to which a DNA damage can be tolerated by the genetic machinery and a cell viability is ensured. So this translational DNA synthesis will decide the cell's viability. This is called as DNA damage tolerance. This is the last resort because the translesion synthesis is inevitably error prone, because the special polymerases are the polymerases with low fidelity, and if they have a low fidelity rate, that will incorporate some errors and that may be mutagenic. The translesion polymerase may correct or may not correct the error and continue the replication. So that corrected part will lead to some sort of mutation. It will be carried on across the generations of the cell. So this is error prone DNA repair mechanism, but this is the last resort. If we can't correct the DNA damage, the cell has to live with it. The polymerase enzyme of special mention here is polymerase eta. Is a low fidelity translation synthesis DNA polymerase. This rescues damaged stalled replication by inserting deoxyribonucleotides opposite the DNA damage sites, resulting in error-free or mutagenic damage bypass. This enzyme is found to have error-free or mutagenic damage bypass. So it may correct or may not correct the damage, but it continues the replication. And the efficiency of this enzyme is it performs the error-free bypass of 8-oxaguanine that we have seen, right? Oxaguanine repair. 8-oxaguanine and thymine dimers, DNA ligands, can be safely bypassed, though with 10 to the power 3 or 10 to the power 2 fold lower efficiency is there, but still it can continue. This was regarding translesion DNA synthesis. This is the last resort of DNA repair mechanisms. Now we'll see the genetic disorders. If these mechanisms or the systems of DNA repair are failed or are defective, so what are the genetic disorders? if the non-homologous end joining repair is defective, we'll see a severe combined immunodeficiency disease, KID. This disease is very important. There is also radiation sensitive severe combined immunodeficiency disease. Then defective homologous repair. Sister chromatid is used as a template for synthesis of DNA. The AT-like disorder or Nijmegen breakage syndrome, NBS, are important too are Bloom syndrome and Werner syndrome. The Rothmund-Thompson syndrome is also there. There is breast cancer susceptibility is found to be increased due to homologous repair defect. So BRCA1 and BRCA2 leading to breast cancer will be due to defective homologous repair. Then there is defective DNA nucleotide excision repair. So the mechanism of nucleotide excision is defective. You will see xeroderma pigmentosum and Cocaine syndrome. There is also trichothiodystrophy due to DNA nucleotide excision repair defect. The defective DNA base excision repair also leads to some disorder that is called as MUTYH associated polyposis. Now coming to the colon. The base excision repair leads to MUTYH associated polyposis, that is MAP. The defective DNA mismatch repair, that is MMR, leads to hereditary non-polyposis colorectal cancer, HNPCC. This is also an important disorder. Okay, so this was regarding genetic disorders due to defective DNA repair mechanisms. So today we have covered various DNA repair mechanisms and the genetic disorders due to any defect in those DNA repair mechanisms. This is the literature which you can use for further studies. And thank you very much for watching the video. If you are not yet subscribed to the channel, please subscribe. And if you like the content, please like and share the video. Don't forget to press the bell button and select all so that you'll get all notifications of the upcoming videos in real time. Thank you very much. Keep watching, keep learning, and keep motivating us.